In this video, I'm going to show you how I made these animations using Adobe Fresco and After Effects. Fresco is Adobe's latest mobile drawing application that has these amazing reactive watercolor and oil paint brushes that create these really natural blending effects. I really wanted this look in animation, but there are no animation tools or timeline in Fresco. So how do we do it? With a little bit of planning and compositing in After Effects, it's not too hard at all. For something really simple, like a bouncing ball, we can start straight in Fresco. On a new layer, I've got a guide for the ground, and I'm going to draw our ball near the top of the canvas here. And I'm going to draw a rough outline of each frame of the animation on this layer. So we've got another ball starting to fall downwards, and another. These will accelerate more as they reach the bottom, stretching out a bit as well. After this contact point where the ball touches the ground, the ball is going to squash and flatten out in the next frame. A classic squash and stretch. And let's keep flattening that for 3 frames. There, the guide is done. Now we're going to follow this guide and draw each frame on a new layer. On a new layer, I'm going to select this watercolor brush and draw the outline of our first circle shape in purple. And then fill in the bottom right area, leaving the area on the top left for our highlight. And then I'm going to change the color of the brush to teal, fill in that highlight, and then blend it with the purple just by touching the edges really. And I'm going to follow that same process for the next frame on a new layer, hiding our first layer so that doesn't get in the way. The variation between the blending of the colors is going to give this animation a nice painterly feel. And then we continue that for the rest of the frames. It really doesn't take that long. Once we get down to our final squashed ball at the bottom, I'm going to make another new layer and draw that sequence following the ball bouncing back up. If you wanted, you could skip this part and just duplicate those falling frames either in Fresco or in After Effects. But because this is so quick and it's so few frames, I think it's worth it in this case. There we are. Now we can export that as a PSD, so we can import it into After Effects. You can get the PSD from your iPad to your computer by using AirDrop or Dropbox or a million other ways. Now we're in After Effects, ready to import it. We can do that by pressing Ctrl and I on the keyboard, or just going up to File, Import. We're going to select our file and make sure we import it as composition and not footage. And select Import and click OK. And that creates a comp with all of our layers separated down here. We need to shorten all of these layers to 1 frame long. So to do that, I'm going to select our bottom pixel layer here, hold Shift and click the top one to select all of them. And because that playhead is at the very start of our composition, we're going to hold Alt and click the right square bracket on our keyboard. And that is going to trim them all down to 1 frame. And while they're selected, we can put them into a sequence by right clicking, selecting Keyframe Assistant, and selecting Sequence Layers, and clicking OK. Now they are all in a sequence. We don't really need this guide layer at the front here, so let's delete that, select them all, and then drag them across. And now we can press Spacebar and watch our animation. I've also got this watercolor paper texture over here that I'm going to drag over on top of our comp. And then I'm going to set that to multiply, just to give it a bit more texture and make it seem a bit more watercolory. That watercolor texture is a series of 4 images of watercolor paper that I took a photo of. Check out my looping textures tutorial for a more in-depth look at that. Or you can download this one in the project file. But I know what you're thinking. A bouncing ball? That's a really simple animation where you didn't even need a timeline or playback to figure out the timing. What about if we want to animate something more complex? For something more ambitious, all you need to do is get your guide frames into a PSD, and then import that PSD into Fresco. You could render them out of After Effects as a PNG sequence, or whatever other animation software you're using, and then drop those into a PSD. What I did for this animation was to make the first rough pass in Photoshop using the Photoshop timeline. And then what we need to do is copy all of these frames and paste them into another PSD. That is because Fresco will not accept PSDs that have a timeline or frame animation in them. Then I sent that PSD to my iPad where I opened it in Fresco and each of these frames was on a new layer. I just paint over each frame in Fresco and then import it into After Effects in the same way to sequence the frames and add our overlaying texture. I've made a short playlist of some related videos that I think you'll enjoy if you've made it this far. I'll see you in the next video, and please consider subscribing if you'd like more of these videos every week.